Hello students, I am Chef Umesh from Chitkara School of Hospitality and today we are going to learn about vegetable and fruit cookery. In this chapter, the objectives to learn are introduction to classification of vegetables, the pigments that are present in the vegetables which impart color to the vegetables, effects of heat on vegetable while cooking them, classifying the different kinds of fruits, uses of fruit in cookery, and the last one, salads and salad dressing, which we will discuss in next part of our video. So let's start. To begin with, I would say from the earliest days as a species, man's primary source of food has been plants. Indeed, they are the ultimate nourishment for all animals. Unlike animals, plants can synthesize organic materials from the minerals, air, and sunlight. And so they are the true origin of proteins, carbohydrates, and other complex molecules to animals' life. As a foodstuff, vegetables also play an important role in the diet of human being. They provide mineral, vitamin, and flavors not available in the meats and fruits. This point should be noted that there are certain minerals and vitamins which we can only obtain from the consumption of vegetables. Be aware of all the vegetables available and know about their texture, nutrition, flavor, and their keeping quality. We'll also learn the method of preparation so that we can take care of the flavors, texture, color and nutrition that are present in vegetable and do not get lost while cooking them. When preparing vegetables, they should be cooked as close to the service time as possible or prepared and balanced without overcooking. Overcooked vegetables lose their color and vitamin and nutrient content. While classifying them, before that, we need to understand that vegetables are the parts of plant that can be eaten raw, cooked or preserved in some form. There are certain vegetables which may fall into more than one category. For example, we have beetroot, which is maroon or purple in color, whose leaves and roots both are consumed. Classifying them on the location basis, there are vegetables which grow above the ground and there are certain vegetables which grow below the grounds. There are certain vegetables which comes under the root category and there are some which come under green leafy category. This diagram shows us different parts of a plant and the vegetables related to it. Starting from fruit, we have certain examples like avocado, cucumber, eggplant, okra, pepper, pumpkin, snap beans, squash and tomato, which are considered as fruits and vegetable both. Then there are certain flowers including artichoke, broccoli and cauliflower. Stems can be classified, or there are certain examples of stems that are consumed as vegetable are anise, asparagus, celery and kohlrabi. There are tubers too, which consists of ginger root, potato, sunchoke or Jerusalem artichoke, etc. Then roots, which consists of beet, carrot, celery, jicama, parsnip, radish, rutabaga, etc. There are certain vegetables which fall under the bulbs category, which includes chives, garlic, onion, shallots, etc. Leaves are also consumed in many parts of the world, and the leafy vegetable consists of beet greens, bok choy or bok choy, which is Chinese chard, then Brussels sprouts, cabbage, chard, Chinese cabbage, etc. Moving to next slide, we will learn about the pigments that are present in different vegetables and the colors related to them. So starting from green colored pigment, which is also known as chlorophyll, and it is majorly present in the green colored vegetables, for example broccoli and kale. Orange pigment or orange color pigment, which is also known as carotene, present in carrot, mango and pumpkin. Red pigment or lycopene, present in tomato. Similarly, there are other pigments like anthocyanin, flavonoids, lutein or zeaxanthin and flavones, which are different in color and related to different vegetables. Coming from the first slide or the picture that told us about the different parts of plants and the vegetables related to them, there is a certain difference between roots and tuberous vegetables. Roots grow deep into the soil, while tubers are large, round, underground stems that grow just below the surface of the soil. If we need to talk about the fruit vegetables like tomato, brinjals, etc., these are certain vegetables which fall into fruit vegetable category, and they come from the flowering plants and contain at least one seed. Therefore, they are technically the fruit of the plant, and they are categorized as vegetable because they are served savory rather than sweet. A similar joke came into my mind, which said that considering tomato as a fruit is a wise thing, but using it in a fruit salad is not wise. That is the reason, as tomato is served savory, that is the reason we call it as a fruit vegetable. Similarly, if we have to talk about bulbous vegetable, these usually grow just below the surface of the ground and produce a fleshy leafy shoot above ground. Bulbs usually consist of layers or clustered segment like onion and shallots. Flowers are the edible flowers of certain vegetables like cauliflower. It is not a decorative flower but a consumptive one. Then broccoli, then gailan, a Chinese sprouting broccoli, and broccoli flower. Fruits we already discussed: tomato, choco, scallop pini, eggplant, capsicum. These all comes under the fruity vegetable category. We also have one more vegetable category, which is an exception and are known as fungi. When referring to vegetables, fungi are commonly known as mushrooms or button mushrooms. There are different varieties like shiitake, oyster, gourmet, brown, wood ear, inokitake, truffle, etc. Leafy vegetables are the edible leaves of the plant, for example bok choy, lettuce, silver beet, spinach, etc. Before moving to other parts or the cooking methods of vegetable, we should also know that stem vegetables are the edible stalks of plant when stalk is the main part of the vegetable, for example asparagus, celery and kohlrabi. Some fact about potato. If we have to describe it, potato, kumara, yam, Jerusalem artichoke or Maori potato, these all are tuberous or root vegetable. Then there is a pigment known as solanin, which is present in potato, which makes it black when we peel it and leave it in the contact of oxygen. So if preparing ahead, peel and drop the potatoes into a bowl of cold water till the actual cooking begins. The discoloration is the work of an enzyme known as polyphenol oxidase, which oxidizes phenolic compounds in the tissues and causes them to condense into brown or gray polymers. There is a fact in between this slide which says that when a seed of a legume is dried, it is called pulse. Usually, pulses are obtained from the plants having bipods. This diagram shows us the difference or basic difference between root and tuber vegetables. For example, we have carrot, which came from the seed, grew down, became elongated, its leaves were above the ground and stem went down the ground. Similarly, potato or tuberous vegetables, they grow below the ground and their plant grows above the ground. Cooking vegetables or the effects of heat on vegetable. Unlike fruit, most vegetables are served cooked. Cooking softens them and makes them palatable. It also intensifies their flavor and makes them easier to chew and digest. Improper cooking and holding techniques can cause vegetable to lose important nutrients and can damage their texture too. Cooking in dry heat is the most efficient way of cooking a vegetable. For example, cooking vegetable with dry heat preserves their flavor and nutrients. Because vegetables are not submerged in water, there is no risk of nutrients leaching into the liquid. Dry cooking techniques such as grilling can also give vegetable interesting flavors. Then other methods of cooking include broiling, grilling, etc. Moving on to fruit cookery. From appetizer to desserts, fruits add texture, nutrition, color and flavor to any meal. Fruits come in different sizes and shapes. They usually are obtained from the flowering plants. They contain at least one seed. Fruits are majorly divided into 8 categories, like citrus fruits, melons, berries, drupes. Drupes are those fruits which have a very thin layer of skin which can be consumed, and only one pit or stone. Then there are palms, grapes, tropical fruits, exotic fruits, etc. A drupe has a soft flesh, thin skin and one pit. We already discussed that. We must also need to understand the types and forms of fruits, and we should also know how to serve and store each of them. This slide gives us an information about the US grading of fruits. Usually, grades are based on a variety of factors like shape, size, texture, color and defects. These grades are US Fancy, which includes premium quality of fruits or the fruits which are fresher than other. Then we have US number 1, which contains good average quality fruits. US number 2 contains medium quality or represents most produce. Then comes the lowest grade quality, which are not suggested or advised for consumption purposes. Now, can we name a fruit, or can we think of a fruit which keeps on ripening even after harvesting? So, the first fruit that comes into my mind is banana. And which one is the fruit which doesn't get ripened after harvesting? So the answer is pineapple. There are certain fruits which keep on ripening, and there are certain fruits which do not ripen even after cooking. Now if we talk about the cooking of fruits, they can be baked, parboiled, blanched, sauteed, etc. Some important fact about legume that we missed earlier is legume is a plant that has double seed pods that contain a single row of seeds, and most of the seeds that are obtained from legumes comes under the category of pulses. And with that, we would end up with today's slide of vegetable and fruit cookery. In our next class, we'll talk about salad and different dressings. For any queries, you may reach out to me at umesh.chukran@chitkara.edu.in. Thank you.